ಆಫರ್ ಮೈ ಅಂಬಲ್ ಪ್ರಣಾಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಲೋಟಸ್ ಪೀಠ ಭಗವಾನ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಸತ್ಯಸಾಯಿ ಬಾಬಾ ಹಿಯರ್ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಟು ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಆನ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಪ್ರೊಸೆಸರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಬೊರೇಟರಿ ಇನ್ ಟುಡೇ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ 20 ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಅನ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಟು ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಎ ಗಿವನ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ 8 ಬಿಟ್ ಅನ್ಸೈನ್ಡ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅಸೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ಬಬಲ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಗೋರಿಥಮ್ ಟು ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಎ ಗಿವನ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನೌ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಸಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಅನ್ಆರ್ಡರ್ಡ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೇಕ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ನೋ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ ಡೇಟಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಇಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅರೇಂಜ್ ದಿಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇನ್ ಅಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಇನ್ ಅಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ದ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಅನ್ಸಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅರೇ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ಸಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅರೇ ಸೊ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಮಾಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಓಕೆ ನಾವು ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಅರೇಂಜ್ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಇನ್ ಅಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಡಿಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಲ್ಗೋರಿಥಮ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಬಲ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಈಪ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಸ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ನಾವು ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಪರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಬಬಲ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಗೋರಿಥಮ್ ನಾವು ಹಿಯರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಎಮ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅರೇ ಎ ಆಫ್ 0 ಟು ಎ ಆಫ್ 5 ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ 6 ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎನ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 6 ಟೋಟಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಅರೇ ದೆನ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಪರ್ ಬಬಲ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಗೋರಿಥಮ್ಸ್ ವಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ n-1 passes ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಒನ್ ವಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ 5 ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಒನ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಅಟ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಸೇ ಪಾಸ್ 2 ವಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ 4 ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪಾಸ್ 3 ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ 4 2 ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್ ಪಾಸ್ 5 ಸೇ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ 1 ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಸೇ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಎನ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಎನ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ n-1 ಪಾಸಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಪರ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಬಲ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಗೋರಿಥಮ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ 2 ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಕಂಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಆಫ್ 0 ವಿತ್ ಎ ಆಫ್ 1 ಎ ಆಫ್ 0 ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ 77 ಎ ಆಫ್ 1 ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ 42 ಎ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅರೇ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಈಚ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ 8 ಬಿಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಡ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಫಾರ್ 16 ಬಿಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನಾವು ಹಿಯರ್ 77 ವಿತ್ 42 ನಾವು ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕಂಪೇರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಈ 77 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 42 ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಡೂ ಇಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಯರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಲಾರ್ಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲಾರ್ಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸೊ ದ ಫಾರ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್ ವಿ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ ಇ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಇಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಲೀವ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಪ್ಲಾನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅರೇಂಜ್ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಇನ್ ಅಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ therefore after comparison we know that first number is greater second number is smaller it requires swap therefore swap this number they are 42 or 77 now compare the 77 with 35 77 with 35 so once again 77 is larger 35 smaller it requires exchange okay compare this 77 with 12 now once again 77 is larger 12 is smaller therefore it is in descending we have to make it is ascending these two number alone therefore it requires swap say exchange swap or exchange next once again here we have to compare 12 with 255 77 with 255 now 77 is smaller 255 is larger it is already in ascending therefore it won't require any exchange that is no swap then compare 255 with 05 255 is larger 05 is smaller therefore it requires exchange or to do exchange actually now the pass 1 is completed so during pass 1 it uses n-1 comparison in this case 5 comparison this is one comparison something like that now after pass 1 we can see the last element okay it's the largest element it is sorted therefore no need to consider once again this element in the comparison therefore if we want to drop this element if you want to drop this particular element we have to reduce one comparison therefore in pass 1 we are using n-1 comparison In past 2, we have to go for n minus 2 comparisons. Okay. During past, this past 1 is over. After past 1, what is your observation? That is, the last element is the largest element, means one element is sorted. Okay. Then past 2, I have to start from beginning. Okay. Compare with first number with second number, 42, 35. Okay, once again it is larger, smaller, it requires exchange. Then 42 with 12, here descending, this larger, smaller, exchange. 42 with 77, then already descending, it won't require any exchange. Then 77, 05, it requires exchange, 05, 77. Therefore, at the end of pass 2, say the second element is sorted. This is the second largest element. This is the first largest element, this is the second largest element, means two element is sorted, means after two pass, two elements are sorted. Now next compare, next pass, you are not supposed to consider this particular element. How to drop this element? Means if you want to drop this element, we have to reduce one more comparison. Therefore, during pass 3, we are going to reduce one more comparison, that is n minus 3 comparisons. Okay. Any doubts here? Now this is at the end of pass 2, this is the status of the array. Then pass 3, I have to start from beginning, 35, 12. Here 35 is the largest, 12 is the smallest, therefore it requires exchange. 35 with 42, 35 is smaller, 42 is larger, it won't require exchange, therefore return as it is. Then 42 with 05, now 42 is larger, 05 is smaller, it requires exchange, therefore 05, 42. Now here after pass 3, so at the end of pass 3, that is third element is sorted. This is the third largest element in the array. Any doubts here? Okay. Then you have to start pass 4. To start from the beginning, 12:35. It is already in ascending. It won't require any exchange. If the first number is smaller, second number is bigger, it won't require any exchange. Therefore, we have to go to next number, 35:05. 35:05, we know that the first number is larger, the second number is smaller, it requires exchange. This is the status of the array after pass 4. At the end of pass 4, the fourth element is sorted. This is the fourth largest element. First, second, third, the fourth largest element. Then pass 5, 12:05. During pass 5, it requires only one comparison. Only one comparison, that is 12:05, larger, smaller, it requires exchange, 05, 12. Now everything, it's over. Now this is the sorted array, 5, 12, 35, 42, 17, 7 and 255. Here I'm talking about unsigned number. Any doubts here? Therefore, here it's a normal bubble sort, it's not efficient bubble sort. In this case, that is, we require for n number, for n elements, we require n minus 1 passes, and in each and every pass we require n minus 1 comparison, next n minus 2 comparison, means in every pass we have to reduce one comparison, because in each and every passes, so one element is sorted. Any doubts here? Shall I proceed? Therefore, now I'm going to implement this particular algorithm in 8086 microprocessor. Okay, dot model small, so as usual, the dot stack to allocate memory, stack memory to store some temporary information. Then this is the array A, 77, 42, 35, 12, 255, 05. I have written everything in decimal. Okay, you can put H here, no problem. Therefore, A is the name of the array, define B, define byte, it indicates, it allocates, it decide the size of each element. The size of each element is 8 bit. Define byte, it allocates 1 byte memory for each number. So AF0 to AF5, so this other number, we can say it's address of the memory location. AF0, the 100, AF1, 101, AF5, 105. Now here, this is a way of finding the length of the array in general. L define word dollar minus A. So dollar gives the ending address, actually basically this address 106. Okay. Then A gives the starting address 100. Therefore, what happened? 106 minus 100, the difference is 6, that 6 goes to L. Therefore, we can able to find the length in general by using this syntax. Now initialize data segment. Now here move BX, L. What is L? Length of the array, that goes to BX. DEC BX, total number of passes. Now BX contains 5, in this case 6. Here BX contains 6, the length of the array is 6, DEC BX decrement, that becomes n minus 1, that is total number of passes. In this case, I am using BX for passes, okay, BX for what? Number of passes, and transfer same BX to CX, so that is total number of comparisons. For total number of comparisons, for comparison purpose, I am using CX. I am using CX as counter for comparison, and BX as a counter for total number of passes. Actually, here we have two loops, the inner loop for comparison, the outer loop for number of passes. So once each and every pass gets over, then we have to come out of the program. The program is completed. Okay, therefore inner loop for number of comparisons, the outer loop for number of passes. Therefore here BX controls outer loop and CX controls inner loop. BX controls outer loop and CX controls inner loop. CX for comparison and BX for number of passes. Now here, that is BX contains 5, transfer the same 5 to CX, then move SI comma 0, it's an index. Now move AL comma A of SI. A is the name of the array, therefore SI gives the first index, SI contains 0, A of 0, the first number comes to AL. Now AL becomes 77. So next is, if you go for a memory, we know that I am just considering two numbers. So I don't want to explain each and everything, just try to understand first comparison. Now AF0 contains 77, AF1 contains 42, therefore 77, 42. Now so we have to transfer first number to AL, now AL contains 77. Then compare, this is go to next location, INCSI, go to next location, compare AL comma AFSI. Compare the content of AL which contains 77 with memory. Which memory here? AF1 means this one. Okay, compare AL with this memory location, that is 42. 77 minus 42 means, comparison means it takes the difference. According to the difference, all flags are affected. After comparison, the content of AL as well as the content of this memory remains same. Only flags are affected. On the base of flags, we have to make the decision. Here we are talking about unsigned number, only magnitude, we are not bothering about sign, we are talking about unsigned number. Therefore we have to use appropriate instruction for unsigned number and signed number. Now here after comparison flags are affected. Now we are talking about ascending order. Now just look here, suppose if the first number is greater, this number is smaller, and this number is larger, then this condition is true, then it is already in ascending, it won't require no exchange, it won't require any exchange. Therefore if first number AL value, content of AL register is less than content of memory, then no exchange. Okay, if this number is lesser, this number is greater, means this condition is true, then go to this memory location, no exchange. Otherwise, in this case, what is the value of AL? 77. What is the value of this memory? 42. 77 is greater than 42. It's not possible to compare directly memory with memory. If you want to compare, the one data must be in the register. Another data may be in the memory, or it may be immediate operand. Therefore, here, first we have to transfer one data to register, that is AL. Okay, AL, then go to next location, compare. Now, AL contains 77. The other data is available in the memory location, that is AF1. Now, the first number is 77, second number is 42. Then, what is your conclusion? The first number is larger, bigger, the second number is smaller. Therefore, this condition is false. It is not below. This is with respect to AL. Therefore, this condition is false. False means what? The first number is larger, the second number is smaller, therefore it requires exchange. Therefore this condition is false. Immediately after this instruction, we have to write instruction to swap, exchange data between these two locations. Okay, now see here, exchange AL with SI. Say here AL, now here we have memory, AF0, AF1 and AL contains 77. So first thing is, exchange the content of AL with memory location A of SI. SI contains one, A of one. Okay, we have to exchange data between AL. Here also same thing, it is not possible to exchange data directly between memory. Exchange with memory to memory not allowed. If you want to exchange, we can exchange register with register, register with memory, memory with register, but memory with memory is not allowed. It is not possible to exchange data directly between memory and memory. If you want to exchange, one data must be in register. That's why here one data is already in register, that is in AL. Now it will exchange the data between this AL and this memory. This 77 comes here and 42 comes to this register. Now see here, now 77 comes here. Here means after execution of this instruction, this comes to this, and this previous value, what is the previous value of this? 42. That 42 goes to this register. Means after executing this particular instruction, what happened? Tell me here. See here, after execution this instruction, it is going to exchange the data between register AL with this memory. A of SI, what is the value of SI? 1, A of 1. That is, what is the purpose of using this instruction? It will exchange data between register and memory. But it is not possible to exchange data directly between memory and memory. It is not allowed. It is not possible. There will be error. Okay. Now, that is 77. Here we have 42. That 42 comes to this. Now, after executing this instruction, that is going to exchange data between register and memory. Now we have smallest element in AL. We have to transfer this 42 to this location. Therefore, AL transfer or move data from AL, which contains 42, to where? Memory. Which memory? A of SI minus 1. What is the value of SI? 1. 1 minus 1, 0. Therefore, A of 0. Now, A of 0 becomes 42. Therefore, if we consider these two location alone, say now it becomes 42 and 77. It is in ascending after a swap, after exchange. So this is the common procedure in bubble sort algorithm. It is very, very important. We have to repeat same thing so many times. Just already explained algorithm about this. Clear? It's a common procedure. So what is the procedure here? We have to compare two numbers. Okay, first number is second number. If first number is smaller, second number is larger, it won't require any exchange for ascending order. Suppose if first number is bigger, the second number is smaller, it requires exchange. Therefore, if you want to exchange data between memory and memory, between memory locations, there is no single instruction. We have to go for these two instructions. If you want to exchange the consecutive memory locations, we require two instructions like this. That is very, very important step. Therefore, if first number is smaller, second number is larger, it won't require exchange. But in this case, we know that the first number is bigger, 77. Here previously we know here 77, here 42. After exchange, here 42, here 77. This is the common procedure. It's very, very important procedure. Okay. Now here loop. Say, I told you already, the inner loop controlled by CX register. Okay, there is a comparison. Therefore, once if you execute loop instruction, decrement CX by 1. If CX is not equal to 0, then go to next comparison. Let's keep repeating that. Then once CX becomes 0, it comes out DAC BX. Means pass 1 is completed. Pass 1 is completed. Jump on not 0. Go back and reinitialize CX value. Reinitialize CX. Then do repeat same thing. So many comparison. N minus 1 comparison. Next N minus 2 comparison. N minus 3 comparison. Therefore, you have to do how many times N minus 1 passes. Then once BX becomes 0, it comes out. That is jump on not 0, next pass. So once BX becomes 0, then come out. That is a terminate. So after coming out of this, so all numbers are sorted in ascending order. Okay. Any doubts here? Okay. Now this is a complete program. Okay. So this is the name of the array. Length. Okay. Now here initialize data segment. BXQ's length of the array. Length of the array. Now DC BX. Why you have to decrement? That is nothing but then we have to reduce one. That is N minus 1 passes. therefore bx controls outer loop, that is number of passes. Cx inner loop controls the total number of comparisons. Then move si comma 0 index, same thing, get first number, go to second location, compare first number with second number. Okay, if it is below, no exchange, come here directly. Okay, reduce the number of comparison, go back. Okay, otherwise if it is first number is greater, second number is smaller, this condition is false, now exchange. So repeat same procedure. Okay, then once bx becomes 0, every pass gets over, then come out and terminate. Any doubts here? Okay, then just now I will give one the demo for this particular program. So this is a program, this is a bubble sort program. Now just I consider 77, 42, 35, 12, FF, 05. I am talking about unsigned number. Now FF is the largest number, 255 in decimal. Now here everything in hexadecimal, 77, 42, the H is there, 12H, the FFH, 05H. Therefore this is the smallest number, 05 is the smallest number and FF is the largest number, and this is the program. So this is the program. Okay. So this is the program. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to compile and execute this program here. Okay, now say massim slash die, that is program name bubble sort, no errors, link bubble sort, no error, code view bubble sort, yes. Okay, now this is a program. A is the name of the array and this is the array elements. This is the, it gives the length, just we can verify, that is, now D display name of the array A. Okay, that is this array before execution, I am talking before execution, as it is 77, 42, 35, 12, FF and last number is 05, and these two locations for length, these two location contains length because L is 16 bit, define what 16 bit. Then remaining things, these are the junk value, garbage value, we are not using these values. Okay, by default memory locations contain some junk value. Now what happened here, now just I want to check the content of L also. Now L contains 6, so this is before execution. If you want to execute complete program in a single stretch, I am going to use command called fi, function key, therefore fi, program terminated normally. Then what happened here, once again D space A. Now see here, 5 smallest number, 5, 12, 35, 42, 77, FF. So all numbers are arranged in ascending order. Then 0600 is the length of the array. Any doubts here? Now I'm going to modify same program for sign number. Okay, same program. Suppose now here just I'm going to modify this. Suppose let it be here 4, 3, 2, 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So minus 4. So this is the array. Just to modify 4, 3, 2, 1. So here which is smallest, minus 4 is the smallest. Which is largest, plus 4 is the largest. We want to arrange this number in ascending order. Which number? This is a sign number. So if you go for a sign number, every procedure remains same, but here this instruction you have to modify. Therefore below equal, above equal, this instruction for unsigned operation. If you want to find the largest, smallest of n number or two number or ascending order, descending order of unsigned number, then you have to go for below equal, above equal. But if you talk about the sign number, you have to go for lesser, less than equal, greater than equal. Now here I am talking about what do you call less than, say jump less than, jump if less than. Okay, here because I am trying to arrange the number in ascending order, then jump if less than, it's for sign number. I am talking about sign number. Therefore save this program. Then once again go to your software. Now here just compile this once again. So no error. See also no error. Go to code view. That is binary search. Sorry, bubble sort. Now here this is the array 4, 3, 2, 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Here which is smallest? Minus 4. Which is largest? Plus 4. So before executing, see the content of the array. Display D, A, name of the array. Here if it is positive number, it will store as it is 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, what? Minus 1 means it's a negative number, it's going to store in 2's complement. Therefore, the 2's complement equivalent of minus 1 is FF, minus 2 FA, minus 3 FD, minus 4 FC. And how many numbers we have here? 8 numbers, so 0, 8, 0, 0. So if it is 16 bit, first it's going to store low order byte, then higher order byte. Then I want to check the content of memory L also. Now what's the length of the array? 8. Then I want to execute this program. If you want to execute completely, you can execute in single step also. So it requires the time. Now just I'm going to execute in a single step by pressing F5. Now program terminated normally. Program terminate normally. Now D A. That is A. See here. FC. What is FC here? Basically minus 4. FC is nothing but minus 4. That is the smallest number. 4. That is here 4 we have. That is the largest number. Therefore FC, FD, FE, FF, 1, 2, 3, 4. That is minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the way of arranging number in ascending order. In ascending order. Correct? Ascending order. Okay, of signed number. Then I want to modify same program for what? Descending order. Descending means what is the largest here? 4 is the largest. Which is smallest? Here we have to get what? 4 descending. The smallest is what? FC. Therefore, just go to this instruction. Jump if greater. Jump if greater. Okay, I want to go for descending order. Then save this program. Then go to same thing. Okay, now compile. Masm, okay, here masm slash zi, no error, link slash evo, bubble sort, no error, cv, bubble sort. Okay, I consider same number. Okay, before execution, see the status of the array. Now same thing, 4, 3, 2, 1, like this. And see the status of the length, that is 8. Okay, fine. Then I'm going to press F5. F5, program terminated normally. Now DA, see here. 4 is the largest descending. 4, 3, 2, 1. What is this? FF, minus 1, minus 2. Minus 3 here, minus 4. Minus 4 is the smallest. So this is the way of arranging the number in ascending order as well as descending order for 8 bit. Then what modification it requires for 16 bit? So just instead of using AL, so you can use AX. Here AX, then here update this by twice. So just I will modify this program. That is here what happened? That is here AL. Okay, now what happened? This is defined byte is there now. Then what we can do is define word. This for 16 bit, define word. Then here what happened? Actually it gives the length if it is in byte. If it is in word, say you can divide this by 2. That use in terms of word. Now move AL comma AF SI is there. What we can do is you can make it AX. Because 16 bit number. Then INCSI, we can go for INC, yes, increment twice. Compare AX instead of AL, AX, I'm talking about 16 bit. Compare AX with AFSI, jump if greater, AX, everything as it is. Here, that is X, fine. Then move SI minus 2 here instead of 1 minus 2. Then here AX, okay. Then DCPX and everything as it is. Clear? Now, what I have to do is just I will go for jump if lesser, jump if below. Okay, I will do it for unsigned number. Then here ascending order na 4 3 2 1 1. Okay, like let it be ascending order na. So let it be some number 1 comma 22 h comma 0 5 h. So let it be. So let consider this number only. So how many numbers we have here? That is 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, 6 numbers we have. We have to arrange this number in ascending order. This one unsigned number. Okay, what is the meaning of this? Actually here 1 2 3 4 5 6, actually 12 bytes. Okay, it gives 12 by 2 6. That is the length of the array. Okay, length of the array. Now just save this program, then go to the software, then compile masm slash vdi bubblesort cllink slash co bubblesort. Okay, cv bubblesort. Now so see the content of the array d a name of the array. Just look here. Now here 4, actually each number, because of define word, each number requires two locations. So here actually 4 is nothing but 0004. 04 is the lower order and 00 is the higher order. Therefore, first it is going to store lower order byte, next higher order byte. This first number 0300 is second number. First lower order byte 02, higher byte next location, that is third data. Here 1, here 22, then last number is what, 05. So what is the length? I calculate, so 6 here, 0600. See here, we can see the length L, that is here 6. How many numbers we have? 1 2 3 4 5 6. Actually dollar minus a gives the length in bytes. How many bytes? 12 bytes. But I need words. How many words are there? 6 words. Therefore divide this by 2, that gives that load total length in terms of words, in terms of 16 bit. Correct, no? In terms of 16 bit, that's why to divide by 2. Therefore now here L is 6. How many numbers we have? 6 numbers. That is the size of each number is 16 bit. Clear? Now this is before execution. That is before execution. Okay, now I'm going to execute this program by pressing F5. Program terminated normally. D A. Now see 1 1 2 3 4 5 5, then 22. After 22, that's the largest number. That 22 is the largest number. Okay, 22 0, that is a largest. Smallest is 1, the largest is 22. Okay, 22. No, this is the length. This is the length and this is a junk value. Any doubts about this? Any doubts? Okay. Say so this is a complete program. Thanks for watching this video. For more videos, visit. Don't forget to subscribe and likes. Thank you.